Everyone, my name is Chris Liebing. I'm from Frankfurt in Germany. I'm a techno DJ and I'm right here in San Francisco talking to Tech Tools, well, talking to you. To sum it up, tractor, four decks here, machine comes out here, my other effects send and returns come out here, and I can work with the machine, control the volumes with the machine, have some extra internal Ableton effects on there. I'm using RME, it's a German company, RME Fireface, and I'm using the USB edition, which is called UC, which has the lowest latency I've ever experienced with any of the RME sound cards. I never really play a track as it is. Like, I think producers out there hate me. They must hate me because they produce a track in a certain way and they wanted to have it played in a certain way. I'll never do this. I usually play totally different bass drums with totally different kind of tracks, add different hi-hats with my machine, or have different synths running from another deck or something like this, you know? The mixing desk is really, sometimes I look down on the mixing desk and you would see something like, for example, this, you know? Like, everything is kind of worked on. And then you look down, it's like, okay, here is like the bass running. Then I have a little bit of high-end coming out here, a little bit of that sound coming out here because I set loops and I work like this. So it turned into a very different way of DJing for me, from just like playing one track after the other. It's just a constant mixing of sounds. You end up sometimes looking down, it's like, wow, this is a really good combination. And I record all my sets. So I always think like, oh, I have to get back to this. This was a really good idea. The combination of that, I have to remember. I never remember. That's the thing. So I can't really go back to whatever happened before. But then again, I don't want to either, because it would limit me to find out more new things. Because if I always go back to, oh, this was working quite well. Of course you have tracks that work with each other. And I play something and I exactly know, oh, this works really well. I do this a lot, you know? But it's it never really works like this, that you have four decks running, a little bit of machine, and you totally remember what you're just doing. It just doesn't work. It's for the moment, and this is what I love. It's just for this moment, and this is what makes every set pretty unique. So one advice would be, go easy on the effects. Even if you have a lot of effects, the best way to use them is that people only notice them when they're supposed to notice them. Like, ah, oh, this is an effect. And some other effects are just amazingly to use in a subtle way. I sometimes have just a little things going on, and it just, that's why monitoring has become so incredibly important to me, because you hear those little differences. So go easy on the effects. And if you start working with a setup which is getting quite complex, start easy and start with only like one thing. Get really familiar with that. And don't add like right away like a million of machines or something like that. You will lose your overview during a set. You will like not know what to do, and you're so busy in trying to figure out what you're doing that you totally lose the flow of the music, you know? This is basically an instrument, and by now I can kind of use it blindly. I know exactly where to put my hands, and every time I replace something with a new controller or something, I need some time to sort of adjust again. Because it would be as if somebody uses a new guitar with another set of strings or whatever, you know? It's just like, because you want to know your equipment. That's the key thing. You know your equipment and then you just practice with it and you play and it flows. Part of the whole system is the tractor laptop. I'm working with two laptops. So I got tractor running here with four decks. I always use Xone 92 Allen & Heath mixer since years and years and years. It's just my favorite mixer, and I basically, as you can see later on, I'm basically using every channel and every EQ and basically every knob on there. The four decks coming out on the four channels of the Allen & Heath mixer right here. And I'm controlling the tractor decks with the new Allen & Heath Xone K2 controllers, which basically control all four decks. The way I map them is this would be one deck, another deck, another deck, and another deck. And the way I use it is deck A and C and B and D. The controllers are connected via Ethernet cables and they're powered via Ethernet as well. And one of them is basically connected to USB of my computer. And then I have a whole other side, which is Ableton Live, which runs effects and Machina, which is the main part of that. I told you I have four decks of Traktor running here. So I basically have two aux channels and two return channels on the Sohn 92 mixer. Aux 1 goes into a reverb effect, basically. So I just do this and I have a send and return reverb effect. With the internal effects of Traktor is always the issue that you have to make dry wet signal, so you have to choose how much of the original signal do I want to lose. And this way I don't lose any of the original channel and I can basically work hands-on. The other one is a delay, and at the moment I'm using a lot my Lexicon PSP 42 plugin, which I have there. I can also change the parameters of the Lexicon. So all these effects getting basically returned on one of the return channels, and then I have the Machina running as a plugin in Ableton Live with mainly six banks full of stuff running. For example, on bank A I have a lot of snares, on bank B I have a lot of different claps, bank C is a lot of closed hi-hats, bank D is a mix of closed and open hi-hats, E and F have quite a selection of rides, crash cymbals, toms, whatever you can think of. So the way I do it is I've made a mapping within Ableton Live. So I control each volume of each bank with my little fader fox. I use the ADS-R for a lot of things, for the rides, for the hi-hats, you know, which is a nice effect. I kind of know what sound is where, sort of, you know. And you just have something running and then you just like, you're like, you just play something in here, you know, you're just like out of the flow. Or you go into step mode and you just say like, I need a simple offbeat hi-hat. But since I felt like this is not enough yet, I can of course use the synth and returns also on my Machina output, because Machina comes out on return one. So if I have something running, I can have a nice reverb, send and return reverb, or all my delay. I also have send and return effects in Ableton. A fat filter, timeless, with a setting that I like. A ping pong delay on another one. I'm a big friend of delays and reverbs. Like, this is what I really, really like. And I think these are the most useful effects anyways you can use in a DJ set, because all the other effects I find they're very distinctive and sometimes they're too subtle that you can't really hear them. Sometimes they're just too far out there that it totally destroys the vibe or anything like this. I'm working with Native Instruments a lot since basically the beginning of Traktor. So every time they can come ask me like, hey, what do you think of a new effect? I was always like, well, a new delay, another delay, and this delay. So for example, the ramp delay is one of these results out of our conversations, which is in there. But on Traktor as well, when we talk about effects, I'll also use a lot of the Gator, the Mulholland Drive. I like that. I'm not really working with sample decks yet, I would say. But I've been in discussion with myself and with a lot of other people about the sample decks, and I'm not using them yet because I have so much stuff running and anyways, you know, it's just like I would be thinking like, where would I, like, how shall I control it? Because the key thing is, if you have things like this running, you don't want to have too much, which is distracting. It should always be controllable and it should always be intuitive, you know, so I don't really have to think what I'm doing.